In this video, we will show you how to add a token-based authentication system to your WeWeb project. Since we're using a Xano backend, you could actually use the native Xano Auth integration in WeWeb to go faster, but that's not really the point of the video. The point of this video is to explain how token-based authentication works so that if you have an existing token-based authentication system in your organization that you need to use for one of your projects, you understand how our plugin works and how token-based authentication works in general. Let's have a look. Okay, so I'm in an empty WeWeb project and I want to add a plugin, an authentication plugin. So like I said, we do have a native integration with Xano Auth. If that's what you're interested in, I invite you to watch the dedicated video on the topic. The purpose of this video is to explain how token-based authentication works. So we'll add the plugin. We'll add it here. And here we're invited to select the auth type. So there are different types of token-based authentication. Xano uses bearer tokens. So we'll select that. And I know that Xano uses bearer tokens because if I look at the Swagger documentation in Xano, if I look at how I can authorize API calls, so authorize calls that are protected by authentication, if I click here, it tells me that it's a bearer authentication system. So in WeWeb, I'm invited to add my user endpoint, and if I have one, a refresh token endpoint. So back in my Xano project, I have a me endpoint. So this is the record that belongs to the auth token. I will copy the endpoint and paste it here. I'll click continue because I don't have a refresh token endpoint. I don't want one. And afterwards, I need to define where the user is redirected when they are not signed in. So typically, it would be a login page. It could be something else. It could be the, you know, it could be the home page if you wanted it that way. What's important is that you need to make sure that the page that you select here is not a private page in WeWeb, because if it's a private page in WeWeb, the user will be caught in an infinite loop. So I click continue and I'm done. I don't actually need to set up rules right away. Okay. Now on my login page, I will add an element. And since I added the token-based auth plugin, I have access to some UI elements that are dedicated to this. So I will drag and drop the login section. And there we go. And here I have my form container that the user can submit. And here you can see the variables, the email input and the password input. So jane@email.com and three. I have this information here. Okay, now on the form container, and I want to make sure I'm on the form container. I can check in the navigator. I'm on the form container. That's fine. I will create a workflow, or rather I will add actions to my workflow. The first action I need to make is an API call to the login endpoint to get an authentication token for my user. So I will copy this endpoint. And in WeWeb, I will add the REST API plugin because I need that plugin to make an API request here. So here we go. And here I will paste the endpoint, the login endpoint. So this is get an authentication token. And if I look at my Swagger documentation, I see here that in the body, in the request I make, I need to send an email and a password, and both are text, they're strings. So in WeWeb, I will add two fields, email, password. And I will bind to the value that are in the form on my page. So the email input and here the password input. All right. So I want to show you something here. Here in my browser and application in the cookies of the editor, if I type in auth, right now it's a, there's nothing. If I test this action, you can see here that I get an authentication token here. Still, nothing happens here in my cookies. And if I go back to my variables, nothing happens here. So even though it says access token here and, you know, my workflow action tells me I got a token, it's not stored here and it's not stored in my navigator either. So I need to use the store token action . Get the result from the previous action. So it's important that I test my first action, otherwise I wouldn't have a result from it. And now if I test my workflow again, I get a token and then it is stored. So suddenly I see it here. This is the value of my token. You see that this value matches this value. And if I go back here, the access token is available here, but still the user is not authenticated. That's because we still need to go and fetch the user. What we did is we retrieved an authentication token, and now we need to get the record of the user that has this authentication token. So back in WeWeb, let me rename this to be very explicit. So store token in user's browser. And then we will add the action fetch user. And here you see we don't have to configure anything. The reason we don't have to configure anything is that we already told the plugin what the endpoint is to get the record of the user with that token. So that's why you don't need to set up anything else here. So let's test this. There we go. Now we have the information from Jane, who is a user in our Xano base. And here we see that we are authenticated. The last thing we'll want to do is we'll want to change page. And we will create a new page with here we go. So back on the form container, here we want to redirect the user to the My Tickets page, and right away we will make sure that the My Tickets page is private, so only authenticated users can access it. Let's try with a different user. So Bob at email. Sign in. Perfect. And here we see now we have this access token and Bob's information. So this is helpful because what we can do is we can, for example, add a sidebar here. And here, instead of Luca, we could bind the information to the information from our user, so Bob. And if we wanted to log out, we could on the secondary button here, we could add a workflow to log out, and this is the action from the token-based auth plugin. And if I go into preview mode, if I go back here and see my auth token, which is Bob's auth token, if I then click on log out, boom, the token is erased from my browser and the user is no longer authenticated. That's it. That's how you add a token-based authentication system in WeWeb. There are other token-based authentication systems, not just bearer tokens, but you get the logic. Step number one, you generate a token for your user. Step number two, you store it in your user's browser. Step number three, you log in that user and get their information with that authentication token. And finally, you redirect them wherever you want to redirect them. So in our case, we chose to change page and redirect the user to a new page, but perhaps your login flow is to open a modal, in which case, after the user is logged in, you would just close that modal and display new information on the page.